So today we are going to learn the central force field physics. There are main four types of forces we generally deal with. The first one is a gravitational force. Then electromagnetic force. Weak nuclear force and strong nuclear force. So out of these four forces which we deal with in physics, this gravitational force and electromagnetic force or the electrostatic force, these are the central forces. The strong nuclear force also, for the some extent, it could be considered as a central force in a few examples which we are going to deal with in a nuclear and particle physics, but for some time it can be considered as a central force. Thus we can see that this central force field, it is really important when we are dealing in a classical mechanics or in a nuclear and particle physics. The central force field has enormous applications. Okay, therefore it is really necessary to study the central force field. Out of this basic four forces, nearly three forces are the central force field, and which shows lots of applications in different fields. Therefore it becomes really necessary to study this central force field. Now let us see what is mean by this central force field. The force, the basic definition of this is, if you are having two points or consider any two charges, so the force of attraction between them, or not attraction, so whatever kind of a force is present between these two bodies or these two charges, when this force is always directed towards the center of this force field, and it is function of this only distance between these two. Suppose this is a positively charged particle and it has its potential field like this. If any another particle, whether it is a positive charge or a negative charge, enters into its potential field, this charge will experience some force. That force is said to be central force because the force is always directed towards the center, and this force is a function of only distance between these two points. It means that the force or the potential which is applied on this force depends only on the distance between these two. For example, if this point is coming closer, more force will be applied. If this point is moving away, then less force will be applied. So the force is a function of the distance only. Such types of forces are called as a central force. For example, if you take a candle, okay, and if you are taking your hand near the candle, whether you are hand is coming from this direction or this direction or from this upper direction, okay, so the whatever heat you are going to feel, okay, that is dependent only on the distance between that candle and your hand. Okay, it is actually direction independent also. Okay, whether your hand is coming from this side or this side or this side, okay, so the heat felt by your hand, that is proportional only to the distance between your hand and the candle. When you are going very near to it, you may get burn your hand, okay, and when you are moving away from that candle, you might not feel any kind of a heat. Okay, so the heat felt by you is only the function of the distance between you and this candle. Okay, such type of a forces are called as a central forces. Okay, and why we are dealing with the central forces? Because there are four forces in a physics generally we deal with, out of which gravitational force, electromagnetic force, and in some cases the strong nuclear force is also a central force field. That's why it's really necessary to study this central force field. So in this unit we are going to deal with the equations of the motion. For the central force field, then we are going to deal with the equation of the orbit and the root of the force cap.